And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 3. Now we just fleed here from Reapers invading the system. In another system we were just in with the N7 abductions and such. Arcturus system and Euler. I only remember it because of Bueller, right, without the B. So let's check out this system. We have its Kite's Nest. Which we have... Pillars of Strength. A Batarian refugee needs the Pillars of Strength to improve his people's morale. Find the pillars in the Kite's Nest and return them to him at the Citadel refugee camp. Right. Okay, so let's check out these planets. Spekilas. Spekilas is a relatively large rock and ice planet known for its deposits of magnetically active periclase, which interferes with some starship scans. Hopefully not ours. Conspiracy theories and pulp adventure claim that secret forces are concealed under the ice. The Reaper invasion force appears to have passed the planet by, which is likely the only insight the organics will ever have into the Reaper's literary taste. next planet. Ilem. A tiny rock and ice planet that is now missing much of its ice, Ilem was part of a grand project by a hegemony dictator known as Grabosht the Mad. His aim was to drop enormous chunks of Ilem's ice on the surfaces of otherwise uninhabitable desert planets in the hopes of creating sustainable lakes and seas. Wow. Wiser heads than he pointed out that diverting a comet was more plausible, but Grabosht executed those who agreed with him. I'm sorry, I can't read right now, guys. Grabosht executed those who disagreed with him. Grabosht's career was surprisingly long given his loose grip on reality, mostly because his projects employed a large number of Batarians. Today, Ilem lies abandoned. Hegemony spy drones still orbit the planet, but it is doubtful anyone on Karshian is paying attention to what data they send back. Okay. End. Varush. Varush is a hydrogen helium gas giant named for an ancient Batarian monarch whose empire spanned continents. He had such a penchant for mating that 0.6% of modern Batarians claim to trace their lineage to him. The planet's moons are named after his many recognized wives. The largest at Bira, concealed Prothean ruins that helped the Batarians develop FTL travel. It is a Batarian point of pride that, since the ruins were damaged by earthquakes, they had less information to go on than other spacefaring species. Okay, I get it. The moon concealed the Prothean ruins, not one of the wives. I'm like, how'd she do that? The Reapers have destroyed all obvious military outposts in Varush's orbit. The Batarians' notorious secrecy, however, may have allowed concealed subterranean facilities on Varush's moons to survive. Okay, next. Karshan. Karshan, the Batarian homeworld, is wrapped less in mystery than in outright lies. Batarian propaganda claims the world has 15 billion inhabitants and an economy that rivals the Asari. Although the legal slave trade does boost the Batarians' profits somewhat, Citadel sanctions have left a paper tiger of an empire, one that fights rivals through deniable terrorist actions rather than the wars of its heyday centuries ago. The Reapers will likely be the death blow to that empire. Almost no information has escaped Karshan since the Reapers destroyed the Kambuis, but Batarian refugees say that resistance has created a bond among the commoners. If a new government can rise from the ashes, that bond may sustain a new Batarian society. Yeah, really. No note of any inhabitants. Desta. A dwarf planet, Desta was explored in the beginnings of the Batarian Space Age and mined for its unusual occurrences of uranium, which was rare on Karshan. Whether the planet has been completely mined out is unclear. Accurate data on the planet was lost after a power struggle within the Batarian government. The Reaper attack has further worsened the information flow. Okay. And what about this asteroid belt? I've taken to exploring these to see if there's planets in among them. I heard that.
I found something.
Yeah, I heard it. Just didn't see it. The wreckage of a fuel depot destroyed by enemy forces. Fuel can be salvaged from the debris. Recovered 300 units of fuel. Wow, 33%. There's more. There are more. I found something on Verush too. Start scanner. Probe away. Got a weapon upgrade kit. Okay. Nothing now, right? I mean, what if there are two things? Nope. Percent recovered. Something here. I know I'm gonna come out there invading, but hopefully I can get away from them. They go so slow. Probe launched. I have to say it. The Pillars of Strength, we found it! Yes! Happy now. We actually fulfilled our quest. 100% recovered. Now let's see if there's anything else here. There is. But we need fuel. Well, let's go to... We got artifacts there too as well. Untrell.
Signal confirmed.
Oh my god. Okay. 100 units of fuel here. On this planet, Adek. Adek is a brutally hot and wet garden world covered with molds and lichen analogs and has many viruses and bacteria lethal to Batarian physiology. The hegemony colonized Adek early in its expansion, but few of the colonists wanted to stay. The result was domination by a class of landed slave owners. A small cadre of well-paid engineers and skilled laborers kept the planet's mechs and infrastructure functioning. Alliance estimates put the planet's Batarian population at just over 6 million, but that number has likely fallen since the Reapers arrived. Alright, let's scan it. Oh, right there. Probe launched. Credits recovered. How much? Okay, we've got all the assets. We can leave this system. Let's look at the other planets. Kloss. That's pretty cool. We got two in one shot like that. Same as with the other system. Kloss is a rock planet with almost no atmosphere to speak of. Consequently, the planet retains fairly little heat, considering how close it orbits to an energetic star. The relatively mild temperature made Kloss attractive for robo-mining, with an emphasis on platinum. The planet also has an abundance of sodium oxide used in the manufacture of lye, but profit margins on that compound are thin by comparison. The Reapers have destroyed the orbital station surrounding Kloss and cut the strands of the space elevators that earlier generations of Batarians used to transport goods to orbit. Well, they're just messing everything up, aren't they? Eska. According to Batarian propaganda, the Batarian population exceeds the Council races. The Batarian military is the most powerful, and the Batarians' unlivable hothouse planets are the hottest and most unlivable. Their best proof of this last point is Eska, which closely orbits the scorching yellow-white star Untrell. Eska's nitrogen-heavy atmosphere might once have held oxygen, but if so, it burned off long ago. Even robo-miners don't care for Eska. Although some modern mining equipment can withstand the heat, the machinery still gets stuck in the soup of molten light metals on the planet's surface. Reaper presence near Eska seems light. Scans reveal wreckage orbiting the planet, likely destroyed hegemony surveillance drones. Anything in the... Always checking this belt here. So many of the systems have these belts, and sometimes there are planets in them. Uza. Uza is a methane-rich gas giant. The wreckage around the Helium-3 infrastructure is unusual. It looks as if fleeing Batarians tried to sever the collection equipment and take it with them when they were attacked. No Reaper ships, functional or otherwise, are immediately detectable, suggesting that the Batarians may have actually turned on each other. How dare they? Okay. Harsa is where the mass relay is, right? That's where he came from. Let's go to Indris. Actually, you know what? Game save, right? Okay, we auto save. Just checking to make sure that really does happen. Because I might have to go back to a previous save if we run out of fuel or are hit by Reapers. Got something interesting over there. The Indris system, Cholis. Cholis is a large rock planet wreathed in a haze of carbon dioxide and xenon. It was discovered by Batarian astronomers during the last century and first visited in the 2150s by hegemony survey teams. A small number of colonists lived in aerostat habitats above its oppressive cloud layer, harvesting carbon dioxide. No habitats can be detected now. Sorry guys, my voice is like messed up. It is likely the Reapers eliminated them or the colonists submerged into the scorching atmosphere in an attempt to hide. Kamala. Kamala is a relatively small but ezo-rich garden world recently colonized by the Batarians. In an unusually open gesture, the Batarians allowed immigration of free citizens of other species, so long as they came from independent colony planets such as those in the Traverse and Terminus, and retained non-citizen status during their stay. These strictures were small obstacles compared to the economic lure of Ezo, and soon the planet boasted spaceports and refineries that considerably enriched the hegemony. The planet enjoyed relative peace and prosperity, with the major lifestyle inconvenience being fresh water shortages due to a dry climate. The Reaper invasion has turned Kamala's cities from affluent oases into a living nightmare. Alliance intelligence suggests that early in the Reaper invasion, a high percentage of the planet's population was captured and converted to husk creatures for future offensives. The processing camps still run night and day, and the troop transports fly legions of cannibals out every hour. For this reason, Alliance Command has put Kamala squarely in its sights for military strikes. Colony founded in 2154, population 2,875,000, all pre-invasion, and capital is Ujan. I need a drink, hold on. Now what have I looked at? I haven't looked at Ramlat. Chulas. Okay, Ramlat. Ramlat is a small rock planet with a thin atmosphere of hydrogen and ethane. During the rush to exploit Kamala for Ezo and other minerals, Ramlat supported a small but steadily growing population. Since the system was bereft of a significant asteroid belt, Ramlat became the go-to location for second-tier miners looking for work. Its tin and gold industry was modestly profitable before the Reaper attack. Today is it a wasteland scarred by craters of kinetic impact weapons. Mm-hmm. Heba. The hydrogen-helium gas giant Heba has an unstable orbit, which over time has led to it clearing the space around it of asteroids and protoplanetary material. As a result, its rings are thick and quite visible. Yes, they are. Finally gotta check out this planet and then the whatever that is there. Maklan. Maklan is the outermost planet of the Indra system, a ball of rock and ice with a methane-argon atmosphere. Like Heba, it has an unstable orbit, but where Heba is believed to have formed closer to the star and gradually moved outward, Maklan is believed to have formed further from Indra's and moved inward. For in the future, Maklan may become a satellite of its gas giant neighbor. I don't know what my problem is tonight, guys. I do apologize. What is this? Caver Station. I guess it's in ruins. Yeah. Alliance intelligence reports that there was once a sizable military space station trailing Heba that was tasked with arming and refueling ships to repel pirates, slave revolts, and foreign invasion. The Reapers wasted little time in destroying it during their conquest of Kamala. How about these planets?
I found something.
Cool. Scan. You really gotta move the mouse for this crap. Come on, man. Probe launched. Governor Grothan Paznas. What is this? ~50% There's another. They're coming. I almost ran into that one.
Evasion successful.
Alright, let's go to Vular if we can make it. We got gas there. No. No? There's no gas at the relay. Or fuel, rather. Just look around here. See, this looks kind of... no. Alright. Urzbat. Urzbat was a wealthy Batarian colony rich in farmland, minerals, and manufacturing infrastructure. Little recent information about it has escaped this section of space, but radio traffic from the planet paints a dire picture. Indoctrinated Batarian officials are offering rewards for every living body brought to the labor camps, slave or not. Really? They're indoctrinated. With the state apparatus at their disposal, repo units are coordinating house-to-house hunts for resistance members and paying those who turn them in. Government propaganda dismisses the smell of the processing ships as a natural byproduct of Reaper energy consumption. Columns of dust from annihilated cities tell the story of those who disobeyed. Oh my god. That's horrible. Too horrible. There's a lot of asteroid belts in this system. Vanna to find the artifacts. But what happens if we run out of fuel and we can't get back? We have to finish Indress. Damn it. A large rock planet, Vanna is covered in prodigious amounts of dry ice, leaving only thin traces of gas for its atmosphere. Uranium deposits drew Batarian miners to Vanna long ago, and when that was exhausted, they moved on to its magnesium. I can't stand the way I can't read. What the hell happened to me? The Reapers have exterminated the colony here, punching holes in the doomed cities and leaving its occupants to asphyxiate. Oh my god. So we got scans, so let's scan.
Signal confirmed.
Oh my god, they're almost on full alertness already. Black market artifacts. Is this what we need to get away from, not get away from... go back to the Citadel and... yeah, we gotta go to, what's his name and give him the special artifacts he needs so that he'll give his special weapons to General or whoever, what's his name. Oh, I'm pretty sure it's a Turian. Excuse me, 50% recovered. If I, recover some more, they're gonna come from... they're not gonna come from here. Only from there, so we can go through that way. Well, we got one more, right?
Reapers eluded.
But the mass relay is over here. We're not gonna make it. Oh my god! I went past it. I'm an idiot. In! Oh my god, I got 25! This Calson Rift. Let's go here, Horsehead Nebula. I just need to fuel up somewhere. I have 25 fuel. And I can't believe I went past that. I went past that system. I'm like Alright, this is gonna be the longest fuel up, guys. Have I been here before? PAX? Well, there's only this. That's all that's here is PAX. Novaria. I'm where Novaria is. I haven't been to Horsehead, right? No, let's check it out while I'm here. No Reaper presence yet. Novaria's here. Okay, so the PAX system in the Horsehead Nebula. Svarog planet. Svarog is PAX's only gas giant, but its temperature, powerful winds, and high orbital velocity make it a poor candidate for helium-3 mining. While Novaria enjoys plentiful deuterium for its fusion plants, it imports all of its helium-3 from out-system. Like most Pegasids, Svarog is thought to have formed outside the frost line of its parent star and migrated inward due to an unstable orbit. Its small size compared to the usual hydrogen-helium gas giants is likely due to hydrodynamic escape, since it orbits closer than 0.015 AU, the planet's atmosphere is likely soon to be consumed. Scientific debate continues on how the other planets in the system survive Svarog's migration, as its gravity may have played havoc with them early in their formation. Orbital distance not applicable. Novaria. Novaria is a small frozen terrestrial world, barely habitable by conventional definitions. It is privately chartered by the Novaria Development Corporation, who lease out labs for research too dangerous or controversial to be performed elsewhere. Your first major quest that we did in first Mass Effect, that I did anyway. You had a choice of three places to go, and we went to Novaria first. The war has brought significant attention to this otherwise obscure planet. Novaria is home to some of the most advanced research in the galaxy, a sure magnet for Cerberus interest. Further, Novaria's mass relay is the stop between the humans' Exodus cluster and the beginning of Solarian space. It is a safe bet that the Solarians will defend their borders to the utmost. Colony founded in 2163, population 405,200, and capital is Port Hanshan. Cool. Fuel depot. Got this little guy here. Morana. Morana is an icy planetoid smaller than Earth's moon. Many planetary geologists suspect it was once an Oort cloud ice dwarf that migrated inwards after an encounter with some other body. While the crust is frozen water, deeper layers are mostly silicates and pockets of magnesium and aluminum. Morana is tidally locked to PAX. The same side always faces the sun. Freaking cold there. Alright, so I got those three planets and this one here, Veles. Veles has a thin atmosphere of xenon and krypton. Most other materials freeze and fall as snow. Its surface is composed of potassium with deposits of magnesium. While investigating the primitive anaerobic life of Veles, binary helix survey teams discovered a cunningly hidden anchorage belonging to the ancient Krogan warlord Moro. Many records and artifacts of the Krogan rebellions were recovered and sold at auction. The empty base is now abandoned. Stuff. So glad we made it. That was so close, especially because I messed up. Scan. There's no Reaper presence, so I can just scan as much as I want, but I don't know if there's anything need to be found. No, of course not. And there's no other systems. Nope. Okay. Oh, I hit that. Okay. Thought I hit a hidden thing. Alright guys, thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode. You know what? Do you have an email? Nope. Okay. We haven't returned their the stuff we found yet, so nobody knows anything. So send us a thank you email. So thanks for watching. See you next time. Endure. In enduring, go strong.